We are in a chapter called Magnetic Effect of Electric Current in Physics. Very important, very useful chapter for public examination. And it is a highly informative chapter. In this chapter, first thing is, who discovered magnetic effect of electric current? Oersted discovered magnetic effect of electric current. Hans Christian Oersted discovered magnetic effect of electric current. What is magnetic effect of electric current? A conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field around it. Where there is an electric current, there is a magnetic field. The magnetic field and electric current are interrelated. That concept was developed by a great scientist by name Oersted. Regarding magnetic field, what is magnetic field? Magnetic field is a region around a magnet where we can experience magnetic force. Magnetic field comprises of magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines having certain properties, like it is having both magnitude and direction, or it is a vector quantity. Magnetic field lines are closed curves. Magnetic field lines are always directed from north to south of the magnet, outside the magnet, and south to north inside the magnet, because it is a closed curve. There is no chance that two magnetic field lines are going to intersect. Like poles repel each other, unlike poles attract each other. These are the properties of magnetic field lines. And we all know that how to draw magnetic field lines around the bar magnet. That is very important for the public examination is concerned. The properties and magnetic field lines of bar magnet is important. Then, a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field, and that magnetic field lines are in the form of concentric circles. That also verified by an experiment. Then, if the magnetic field lines are there around the conductor carrying electric current, how to identify the direction of the magnetic field lines? Direction of the magnetic field lines is identified by right hand thumb rule. There, the thumb indicates the direction of the electric current and finger tips represent the direction of the magnetic field lines. Then I told you, what happens when the electric current is passed through a circular loop? We are going to get a uniform magnetic field at the center of the loop. At the end of this particular content, we understood that there are three different shapes are given for the different magnetic fields. One is the magnetic field around the bar magnet, magnetic field around the straight conductor carrying electric current. It is in the form of circular concentric circles, and the magnetic field lines of uniform magnetic field. Then where we are using this knowledge of magnetic field? For development of certain devices called solenoid. Solenoid is used for making electromagnets. Electromagnets are used in various devices used by man. And such as mixies, washing machines, motors, dynamos, they're all using this solenoid. But when we understand the magnetic field lines around the solenoid, we can able to understand there are two different types of magnetic field are present in the solenoid. One is the magnetic field around the solenoid. It is, looks like a magnetic field of a bar magnet. Whereas the magnetic field inside the solenoid is a uniform magnetic field. Then comes the Ampere experiment. What happens when a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field? Ampere told that conductor experiences a force and turns. And that force is called the motor force. There we have to identify the direction of the motion of the conductor, magnetic field and the electric current. That is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule gives the relationship between motion of the conductor, magnetic field and electric current. And how to state this Fleming's left hand rule? Stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Forefinger starts with F, represent the direction of the magnetic field. Field starts with F. Middle finger, center finger indicates the direction of, center finger means C, indicates the direction of the current. What current? Electric current. And then thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. Using that, I told you what is motor. Motor is a device. This is a very important part of the lesson called, in this particular lesson, motor, electric motor. Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. we can identify two different types of motor, AC motor and a DC motor. Motor works on the principle of the force experienced by a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. And the working of a motor is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. In the previous class, I able to write the diagram of the motor and the different parts of the motor. Motor comprises of a rectangular coil with a very fine insulated copper wire. Coil is connected to the copper split rings. Coil and split rings together called armature. Armature is made to rotate on its axis. Coil is kept between the poles of a powerful magnet. And copper split rings are attached to carbon brushes. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. And we are able to write the diagram. And I think that you are all able to write the diagram because it is an area where we are going to get 3 marks in the public examination. You can't become lazy for this particular unit because it is a scoring area. Anyhow, you are going to face the public examination this year. Therefore, practice the diagram of DC motor or electric motor. Today's class, what I am going to do is, I am going to explain the working of a DC motor with the help of a Fleming's left hand rule. For the explanation, the first thing is working of DC motor. Very interesting content it is, and very useful content, and all brilliant students, they are able to understand and like the beauty of working of a DC motor. DC motor, how nicely it works. See, the first thing is, motor comprises, first we have to understand the diagram of the motor. Again, I write the diagram of the motor. This is very important for the examination point of view. Motor comprises of a rectangular coil. I already told this particular content in the previous class. ABCD, the coil is named as ABCD. And this coil is connected to, coil is made up of very fine insulated copper wire. And this coil is connected to two copper split rings. I mentioned the name given in the textbook only now. Coil and copper split rings. Coil and copper split rings together called armature. And armature is made to rotate on its axis. Now I write the axis here. This is the axis. There is an axle rod which is connecting these two. By that what happens? When you rotate the coil, copper split rings also rotate. And this coil is placed between the poles of a powerful magnet. Your magnetic pole should be there. One is north pole, another one is south pole. Always you have to write the diagram neatly. Why? Because you have to score marks. You have to write neatly. Diagram don't make laziness while writing the diagram. Always write neatly. By that you can impress the evaluator. See, these two are magnets, north pole and south pole. The next is, this copper split rings are attached to, these two are copper split rings, they are attached to two carbon brushes. Carbon means graphite. Carbon is a non-metal. We all know that non-metal is a bad conductor of electricity. But there is one allotropic form of carbon that is called the graphite. Graphite is a good conductor of electricity, and that graphite is used for making the brushes. They are called the carbon brushes. By that what happens? Now I write the name of the name given in the textbook. Carbon is a non-metal whereas copper is a metal. Therefore, we can avoid the sonorous property. When a metal touches a metal, it produces, because it has to rotate. When rotate, suppose these two P and Q, carbon brushes, are instead of making like carbon, if it is made like copper, then what happens when the copper split ring rotates? Copper touches the copper. When copper touches the copper, it produces sound. To minimize the sound, these two are made by a brush of carbon. Carbon is a non-metal, copper is a metal, therefore the sonorous property we can avoid. There is no sound here. We have to minimize the sound. If a fan is making sound, there is a problem in the brush.
The brush is made by carbon graphite brush, and this brushes are connected to a DC source externally. Here the copper carbon brushes are connected to a DC source externally. Now externally means what? A source is having plus or minus. Source is having a plus or minus at the end of color of the chalk, right? Plus and minus. Now we are going to explain, understand the working of a DC motor. How nice. The first step is the electric current. We have to follow the path of the current. First step of understanding the working of a DC motor is, first you have to understand in which path, what is the path of the electric current in this motor. See, current comes from plus like this. First it goes to P, it is a carbon brush. Then it goes to the X, that is X is what? Copper split ring, one half, half of the copper split ring. From X it travels like this, from X it cannot go to the Y because it is a split ring, there is a gap. From the X it goes to A, B, C, D, and it comes to the Y, Q, and finally it goes to the negative. See, this is the path of the current. And now try to understand. This is the path of the current. Now, according to Ampere's experiment, a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. Now, the coil is kept inside the magnetic field. The coil, when we allow the current to pass through a coil, the each and every part of the coil is current carrying conductor. The current carrying conductor is placed between the magnetic pole. Then what happens? It experiences a force. By the force, it has to turn, it has to rotate. That has to verify by Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule explains in which direction this armature has to rotate. For that purpose, what happens? See, in this figure, the direction of the electric current is ABCD. Direction of the electric current is ABCD. In Fleming's left hand rule, which finger represents the direction of the electric current? Middle finger. Therefore, I take the conductor AB. I can take the conductor AB or I can take the conductor CD also. I take the conductor AB. I can't keep like this. If I keep like this, the finger is directing towards A from B. Therefore, it is wrong. I should keep it like this. The middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current from A to B. And forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Direction of the magnetic field is always from north to south. Now I keep my fingers on the conductor AB. Middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Right? Now where the thumb is indicating? Thumb is indicating that AB is moving away from you. See, there is two type of motion for AB. AB can come towards you or away from you. That is identified by what? The direction of the thumb. Therefore, when I keep the finger, the middle finger is showing the direction of the electric current. Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Now, AB is moving away from you. When AB is moving away from you, CD is going to come towards you. See, it turns like this. AB is moving away, CD is coming towards you. Suppose if I keep the fingers for the C, see, direction of the electric current is identified by what? Middle finger. And forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Now the thumb indicates the direction towards you. Therefore, CD is moving towards you. AD is moving away from you. Therefore, the direction of the armature should be mentioned like this. like this. CD is coming towards you and AB is moving away from you. Therefore, it takes one rotation, one half rotation. It turns like this, one tilt. We can see the tilt in the case of an armature. When the armature tilts, the whole structure changes. See, what happens? I like the structure. See, now I won't write the names, you have to identify the names. This is coil. Coil is connected to two copper split rings. Coil and split rings together called armature. Armature it is. And coil is placed between the poles of a magnet. This is north pole and this is south pole. Because when any rotation takes place, only the armature rotates. The magnet doesn't rotate. Therefore, this is north and south only. And here, carbon brushes are there. Carbon brushes is not going to rotate. Carbon brushes is not going to rotate. Because carbon brushes are attached to the copper split rings. They are not connected, they are only attached, they are only touching. And therefore, the name of the carbon brushes is remain as PQ. PQ. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source externally, it is also remain the same. It is not going to rotate. This is plus and this is minus. Now, once the current goes to the direction ABC, it turns. It turns, now the rotation becomes, the armature completed half revolution, half rotation. By that what happened? This becomes D, C, B, A. A, B, C, D becomes D, C, B, A. And this X, Y becomes Y, X. One half turn. If you understand that first figure and the second figure together, if you see, you can easily understand this made one half rotation. Now, to understand the direction here, the current comes here, from here, it goes to P, P to Y, Y to here, it becomes DCBA, it becomes DCBA, then goes to X and goes to the negative terminal. If here, if I verify the rotation, the current goes like this, because the current goes in the coil in the direction DCBA, because of the force experienced by the coil has to rotate. And the direction of the rotation of the coil is verified by Fleming's left hand rule. Now I keep my finger on DC. See, DC. DC is the direction of the current. Four finger indicate the direction of the magnetic field. Now CD, the CD part of the coil is moving away from you. And AB part of the coil moving towards you. Therefore, it rotates like this. First one, it is ABCD, take one rotation, one half rotation, it becomes DCBA. When it is DCBA, it takes half rotation, again it becomes ABCD. Therefore, the direction of the current is continuously changing from ABCD to DCBA in every half rotation, and that change of the direction is made by the copper split rings. Therefore, copper split rings is called the commutator. Commutator is the part of the DC motor that changes, that helps to change the direction of the electric current in every half rotation. See, to understand the working of a motor, you should be well versed with the Fleming's left hand rule. I repeat once again, see, very simple it is. We go to the first figure. See, in this figure, I call this as first figure. What I tell you is, in the figure 1, the direction of the electric current in the coil is ABCD. When the coil becomes a conductor carrying electric current, it experiences a force because it is placed inside the magnetic field and turns and makes half rotation. And makes how many rotation? Half rotation. When it makes half rotation, the direction of the rotation is verified by
Fleming's left hand rule.
In figure 2, the direction of the electric current in the coil is DCBA. Due to the force experienced by the coil rotates and completes another half rotation. First half rotation, now another half rotation. Half plus half becomes one rotation. In one rotation, the direction of the current changes twice. In one rotation, direction of the current changes twice. The first half direction is ABCD. The second half, the direction of the electric current is DCBA. The change of direction of the electric current is done with the help of a switch called copper split rings, and the copper split rings are also called commutator. And this is the working of a DC motor. DC motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. When you provide the electric current, it starts rotating. How it rotates? It rotates, the one rotation is divided into half plus half. In half rotation, the direction of the current is ABCD. The next half rotation, the direction of the current is DCB. ABCD, DCB, ABCD, DCB. Continuously it starts rotating. And the direction of the rotation is verified by the Fleming's left hand. Right? Therefore, if they ask you to write the working of a DC motor, you have to write two diagrams here. In the first diagram, you have to write ABCD. In the second figure, you have to write DCBA. When you write ABCD, it is X by Y. When you write DCBA, it becomes Y by X. This also rotates. The whole part is rotating. The rotation is due to the force experienced by the coil, because it is placed between the poles of a magnet when current is passing through the conductor. Therefore, the explanation part, what you have to write two diagrams. What you have to do is, in figure 1, direction of the electric current in the coil is ABCD. Due to the force experienced by the coil, armature rotates and completes half rotation. Completes how many rotation? Half rotation. The direction of the rotation of the armature is verified by Fleming's left hand rule. In second figure, the direction of the electric current in the coil is DCBA. Due to the force on the coil, armature rotates and completes another half rotation. The direction of the rotation of the armature is verified by Fleming's left hand rule. This is what you have to write for explaining the working of a DC motor. In DC motor, every half rotation, direction of the current changes. The direction of the current changes but with the help of what? The copper split rings. And copper split rings are called commutator. Commutator. They may ask a question, what is commutator? Commutator is a part of a motor. Commutator helps the coil to change the direction of the current in every half rotation. Every half rotation, the direction of the electric current changes in the coil. First half rotation it is ABCD, second half rotation it is DCBA. Once you write the diagram and understand the first time it is ABCD, second time it is DCBA, you can easily write the working of a DC motor with the help of a Fleming's left hand rule. Now you understood what is a motor. Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. The motor, what we studied in 10th standard, is DC motor or simple electrical motor. Motor comprises of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire. Coil is connected to two copper split rings, X and Y. Coil and copper split rings together called armature. Coil is placed between the poles of a powerful magnet, and copper split rings are attached to two carbon brushes, P and Q. And carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. And the working of a DC motor is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. For that purpose, you have to write two diagrams, diagram 1 and diagram 2, because the motor completes only half rotation. The first half rotation, the direction of the current is ABCD. The next half rotation, the direction of the current becomes DCBA. And the direction of the current changes by copper split rings. Therefore, copper split rings are called commutator. Commutator is the part of the motor that helps to make the
helps to change the direction of the electric current in every half rotation. Name the device that helps to change the direction of the electric current in every half rotation. Commutator. Commutator is nothing but a copper split rings. Right? The role of the commutator is it has to help the coil to get the direction in different directions in every half rotation. Now the question is, this is a simple electric motor. It is a toy motor. But what is the difference between this motor and the commercial motor? Commercial motor means the motor that is used in an electric fan or a motor what we use to pump out water. In that motor and this motor, when we compare, what is the difference? This particular question they asked in the model question paper. What is motor? Draw a neat diagram of the motor and how the motor is different from, how the simple electric motor is different from the commercial motor. Commercial means the motor which is used in the industries, household and for any other devices we use motors, how they are different from this particular motor. The answer is very simple. We are now right three stages there. How this motor is different from the commercial motor? Three differences we can list out. One is, the first difference is, so far what we understood in this particular chapter is, electromagnets are more powerful than the natural magnets. We can make a very powerful magnet by using a solenoid. Therefore, the commercial motor should have a very powerful motor. Normal motors, normal magnets are not sufficient. We require a very powerful magnet. Therefore, instead of permanent magnets like this, simple motor we use permanent magnets, but in the commercial motors we use electromagnets. Electromagnets are used. Electromagnets. Electromagnets are used in commercial motors. In a simple motor we use permanent magnets, natural magnets. But in commercial means in industries, in the industrial motor, we use electromagnets instead of natural magnets. Because electromagnets can be made very powerful. We want a very powerful magnet. Therefore, we always use electromagnets instead of natural magnets used in simple electric motors. We studied with the natural magnets. And the commercial motor, instead of these magnets, we have electromagnets. Solenoids are there. They use solenoids and make very strong magnets. One. Second thing is, here there is a coil. What is coil? Coil is nothing but we have a number of turns of insulated copper wire. What they do is, here the normal electric motor, we have a turns. It may be 100 turns or 200 turns, but in a commercial motors, thousands of turns are there. Therefore, we use more number of turns. By increasing the number of turns of insulated copper wire is very high. Very heavy. Large number of turns of the copper wire, insulated copper wires are used in commercial motors, whereas in the simple motor we use hundreds of turns of the insulated copper wire. And third one is, see, this has to get magnetized. I told you while explaining the Ampere's experiment. When we put a switch, here there are two magnetic fields. One is the magnetic field of the natural magnet. Another one is a magnetic field produced by a current carrying conductor kept inside the magnetic field. There are two magnetic fields are there. I repeat once again, a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field. And there is already a magnetic field of the permanent magnetic field. Therefore, when it is on, we can able to find two magnetic fields. This magnetic field, I told you, in the commercial devices, we use electromagnets, very powerful magnets. This magnet should also become very powerful. To make that powerful magnet,
What we do is, we insert a soft iron coat. A core is made for the middle part. We solder a soft iron. It is a pure iron. Soft iron core we weld here. We call this as axle also. And this is made by soft iron. Soft iron. The advantage of soft iron is, soft iron can magnetize easily and strongly, and also it loses magnetic property quickly. It gains and loses magnetic property very quickly. It acquires magnetic property very nicely. Therefore, soft iron core is used in the commercial motors. How the commercial motor is different from the simple electric motor? One, in commercial motor, electromagnets are used instead of permanent magnets. Two, in commercial magnets, we use more number of turns in the case of a coil. Third one, we use soft iron core. These three things to be modified to make a commercial motor. That is the major difference between a commercial motor and a simple electric motor. We studied in 10th standard a simple electric motor, and the working of a motor is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. Therefore, while explaining motor, the whole unit of a motor, you should understand what is motor. Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. How many types of motors are there? AC motor and a DC motor. AC motor is a commercial motor. DC motor is a simple electric motor. And the next is, what is the principle of the working of a motor? The principle of the working of a motor is based on the force experienced by a current carrying conductor kept inside the magnetic field. And how to explain the working of a motor? Working of a motor is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. Which are the parts of the motor? Motor is having armature. Armature is having two parts. One is the coil, another one is the copper split rings. And coil and the split rings, that together call armature. Armature is made to rotate on its axis. Coil is placed between the poles of a magnet. Copper split rings are attached to carbon brushes. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. To explain the working, in the first case, the direction of the electric current in the coil is ABCD. Due to the force experienced by the coil, armature rotates and completes how many rotation? Half rotation. In the second half rotation, in the next half rotation, the direction of the current is DCBA. DCBA. And here also it rotates in the same direction and completes another half rotation. Now the question arises, who help us to change the direction of the current in the coil ABCD and DCBA? Commutator. Commutator, which is the commutator? Copper split rings is the commutator. Then, is this motor is used for commercial purpose? No. Commercial motors are different from this motor. In what factors these commercial motors are better than this motor? One, in the simple motor we use permanent magnets, in commercial motors we use electromagnets. Second one is, in commercial motors we should have more number of turns in the coil. Third one is, we have to use soft iron core. Soft iron is a pure iron, it gains and loses magnetic property quickly. That you have to understand. This is the area of a motor. Once you understand the diagram working of a motor, I tell you, you are going to score 3 to 4 marks in the public examination. See yesterday's video and today's video. 13 years, 2-3 times you see, you can easily get 4 marks.